God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
I am so delighted to see how many people show up at church when church is closed. The church offices were closed this week, and it was one of the busiest times that I've seen yet. I'm really grateful for all of the hands that came and joined and helped with the Advent changing of the seasons, the linens. You'll notice the creche is set up out front. The crew that came to paint the carriage house also repainted the creche as a surprise for us. I know, right? That is just so sweet. So you'll notice big changes around here today, and I am so thankful for that, all of the many hands that came to church this week. We have had a good turnout and a good response for our junior youth group program. So as that program builds, we'll need some parents to take turns helping me out. So I need another chaperone once a week on Mondays. And I'll need to know from families if Monday is not a great day. I've had a vote for a Tuesday or a Wednesday. So I'm flexible. If we need to switch the day, we can switch the day. But we do need another chaperone, and eventually we'll need the whole congregation to take turns providing a simple dinner. Because right now it's just pizza. Eventually, middle schoolers do get tired of pizza. It's going to take several weeks, but eventually they will get tired of pizza. We have a very short deadline here for the Giving Tree. The donations are due on Tuesday for that. And we will need, beyond today, we'll need some Advent candle lighters for the next 3 weeks. And we need some folks to sign up for the Christmas Story Stroll. We've had the search committee has signed up for one of the stations. We have four more stations. We have a few angels signed up at one of the stations, so we need some other folks to join in and sign up. The Christmas Story Stroll will be our live outdoor nativity, and the entire congregation is invited to come and help out with that in the same way that we did Trunk or Treat, and we'll open it for the entire community to come and see the Christmas story as told only BCC could do, really. I can imagine the animals that we get for that. Who knows? The chancel fund donations begin today. So there's more information about that in our bulletins. And welcome to everyone who's joining us in person and online today. Really delighted. We have some candles hiding around in the sanctuary today. You'll see more about that in a few minutes. Anyone have any announcements for the congregation this morning that I've missed? Well, having no other announcements, we are delighted to have Amanda back with us this morning.
People who walk in darkness have seen a great light. The light will shine upon them. May it shine brightly tonight.
Will you be ready for the light to
Will you be waiting? Will you be searching for a Savior and a King? Will you be ready for the light? Ready for the light to shine upon you? True light is coming. Look for a bright star in the east. Look for the Christ child born in a manger. They will find the Prince of Peace. Will you be ready for the light? Ready for the light to shine upon you? Will you be ready for the light? Ready for the light to shine? Will you be ready? Ready for the light to shine? Ready for the light to
the people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in a land of deep darkness, on them has light shined.
Today, today is the first Sunday in Advent. It's the beginning of our celebration of the birth of Jesus, who brought light into the lives of all people. We light the first Advent candle.
Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life."
Thank you. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Come into our midst, come into our hearts, come into our homes and our community, into our schools and workplaces. May we welcome you everywhere, making room for you, preparing for you, anticipating your arrival with joy and reverence. We commit this season of Advent to become ready. Shine your light into those nooks and crannies we keep in the shadows. Sweep the cobwebs from our long doubt and fear. Repair our torn and wounded places. We long for your arrival. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Amen. And if you would join me in the Lord's Prayer, please. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. I'd like to invite all the kiddos to come on up. I need some help. Sure where I'm going, but I'll come over here. So how is everybody?
Good.
Oh, I'm well, thank you. Everybody have a good Thanksgiving? Lots of turkey, family, friends, ready to go back to school tomorrow? Yeah. So this is a time that we're getting ready, right? So it's called Advent, and we've got these Advent candles up here. And when Advent came around, I was like, does everybody know what this is all about? What are we doing here? So I thought I would have you guys help me figure out or sort out what Advent is really about. So I'm gonna need help making a wreath, okay? It's gonna be kind of a funky wreath, but a wreath nonetheless. Lucy, can you take this end? Just take the end. And I'm gonna have you take a piece over here. Jordan, can you scooch around behind your sister? Everybody, I want you to make like a circle. Do you see these numbers on the floor? Can we make a circle around these numbers? So you're going to go that way. You're going to go that way. And you're going to go this way. Okay? So we're just going to make, we're going to keep a space is what I'm trying to do. We're going to keep a space right here. And why don't you come around over here? Take a piece. Everybody take a piece. All right. Can you hold on to a piece? There's plenty of it. You may have to get a little close to somebody, I'm afraid. All right, everybody get a piece? Okay, so now I need the candles. And maybe our wreath holders can hold our greens up a little bit high. All right, so now we have a little bit of information from each of our candles. Candle number one. Oh, wait, here, wait. Can you do it together? Can you do all of it?
I am the first candle, the candle of hope. Because of the difficult stories of last year, let it burn through these weeks. As a beacon to become the light of hope, Let this candle guide us to God's presence among us, leading us to God's justice and joy in the service of peace.
I am the second candle, the candle of peace, a light offering comfort to weary spirits. Let its glow remind us of God's tender care and warm our lives in the light of peace. Let this candle guide us to God's presence in our midst and lead us to God's justice and joy in the service of love.
I am the third candle, the candle of joy. Let us delight in the sparkle of its outrageous reminder to rejoice. Let this candle's flame cast light into shadowy places and show where there is work to be done. Let a community of builders be formed in the light of joy. Let joy find home in our hearts and make space for God's presence as we work for justice and peace in the service of love.
I am the fourth candle. I am the fourth candle, the candle of love. With the candle, we marvel at God's desire to be one with us. Let its flame summon the hearts that have grown cold into the warmth of the people living into the light of love. Fill our lives with love and make room for friends and strangers who desire to know God as we work for justice and peace in the service of hope.
All right, I hope that explains things a little bit to everybody out there. Can everybody say a little prayer with me? Dear God, thank you for a time of getting ready. Thank you for a time of Advent. Thank you for a time of hope, peace, joy, and love. Amen. Happy tree hunting, everybody. You can head back.
In today's prayers, we keep in our memory Alice Denon Epstein, Betsy Brenner's mom, in whose name the first arrangement of flowers is given on the 25th anniversary of her passing. And in memory of Andy, Bethia's husband, on what would have been his 95th birthday. For our prayers today, I'll need a volunteer to grab the microphone on the other side. Otherwise, I can go back and forth. Thank you so much. And I were putting the service together, we just knew somebody would be willing and able. Do we have any prayer requests from the congregation?
I'm not so good at this, I guess. Yeah. Hi, I'd like to ask for prayers for my best friend's sister. She's having surgery tomorrow for pancreatic cancer.
Am I saying something? Can we join in prayers for your best friend's sister by saying amen?
Amen.
I'd like to ask for prayers for my husband, Stephen Venuti, as he struggles with pneumonia following open heart surgery.
Let us all join in healing prayers for Stephen, speedy recovery. In the name of God, amen.
Amen.
Good morning. I'd like to raise up a friend and colleague, a gentleman by the name of Donald Ross, who suffered a heart attack this week. I understand he's doing well, but just like to raise him up in our prayers. Thank you.
For Donald, Lord God, for your healing to be with him and his family and his colleagues and friends, let us all join together. Amen.
Oh God, this beautiful Advent stirs such hope in us. In this season we find light, joy, and peace, all glimpses of the world to come. May these next 4 weeks be scarce and holy, filled with true love for mankind. We want to see Jesus and to let him be seen by all we meet. Help us to drink in every moment, to behold the beauty and majesty, and worship the King who was and is to come. Amen.
Today's scripture reading comes from the Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said, "There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on the earth distress among nations confused. By the roaring of the seas and the waves, people will faint from fear and foreboding of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now, when these things begin to take place, stand up and raise your heads, because your redemption is drawing near." Then Jesus told them a parable. "Look at the fig tree and all the trees. As soon as they sprout leaves, you can see for yourselves and know that summer is always near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Be on guard, so that your hearts are not weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of this life, and that day catch you unexpectedly like a trap. For it will come upon all who live on the face of the whole earth. Be alert at all times, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that will take place and to stand before the Son of Man. Holy One, as we enter the Advent season, prepare our hearts and minds to hear your word and remember that you came among us. We pray also for our senior pastor, Dale and Elizabeth, that your spirit abide with them in their absence. Be alert, praying at all times. I'm sure by now, in all of the moving parts of today's service, you've noticed that something's different this morning in the church, or something glaringly, obviously different up front. There's decorations in the church, there's decorations in the front lawn, there's wreaths on the front door. Our Advent wreath has just been lit. The first candle has been lit, which means today is the first Sunday in Advent. Which makes this the first day of the church calendar. Today's the church's New Year's Day. It's the first day of the new liturgical calendar. It's the first day of the new lectionary cycle. So things change on the first Sunday in Advent. I really appreciated all of our candles and wreaths this morning. Fantastic embodied candles and wreath. Advent means coming. It's the church's season of preparation for the coming of Jesus Christ, both in the nativity of the Messiah, or the birth of the baby Jesus that we celebrate at Christmas, and the coming of Jesus as the Son of Man that we just read about in today's scripture. One of the stories is comforting and familiar, and the other is uncomfortable. It's apocalyptic. It's language about end times. It's disquieting. The story of the Nativity brings all the warm, fuzzy feelings of Christmas. The angel Gabriel announces the miraculous birth prophecies to Zechariah and Elizabeth, who are to become the parents of John in their old age. John becomes the Baptist. That's one of the stories we'll hear over the next few weeks. The same angel also announces to Joseph and Mary that they will be the earthly parents of the Messiah. In this year's lectionary, we'll follow the story of John the Baptist and John's earthly ministry to prepare the way for Jesus's earthly ministry. And we'll hear the story of Mary's relationship to John's parents, Zechariah and Elizabeth, and we'll hear Mary's prayer in response to Elizabeth's prophetic message. But in today's message, Jesus reminds us of the apocalyptic language from the prophet Daniel, that there will be signs in the sun, in the moon, and in the stars, and that the earth will face distress of nations and perplexity and confusion, the sea and the waves roaring, and human hearts failing in fear and expectation. Jesus reminds us in the face of calamity to be watchful and to pray always, to be attentive to his coming and to one another. And for about 2,000 years, believers have been reminded of these apocalyptic texts each time humanity has faced calamity, each time that there have been uprisings amongst nations, each time that celestial bodies have done something wondrous, each time that there is distress in weather patterns, when we see earthquakes, when we see floods, when we see fires. Humanity has read the signs as prophetic and apocalyptic and has attempted to superimpose the scripture onto the current event and then ask questions about, are these the times that the Bible talks about? Is this the end of days? Are these the apocalyptic times? Certainly, over the past 20 months, I've heard many people ask these questions. Many people in the nursing home that I was helping at ask, were these the end of days? When our suffering is so unbearable that it must be apocalyptic. Certainly, the pandemic, the civil unrest, the weather changes, all the natural disasters that we've faced, the resulting suffering on all of us has caused us to wonder if what we've been through is biblical, if it's prophetic, is it apocalyptic? The Gospel of Mark tells us, Jesus says, take heed that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name. When you see these signs, some will come saying, I am he. But Jesus says, take heart, do not be troubled. And in today's message from Luke, Jesus tells us that when we see these signs, stand up, be on guard. Lift your heads, take heed, lest your hearts be weighed down. Watch and pray. You see, when we come into conflict with natural disaster, apocalyptic events, Jesus tells us, don't be afraid. Jesus tells us, watch and pray. Take heed, stand up, watch and pray. Take heart. Jesus's promises, Jesus's covenant that his words will not pass away are true. He says, watch and pray always. A few weeks ago on Stewardship Sunday, I spoke about two commandments. To love God, which I said was a vertical relationship, and to love your neighbor, which I said was a horizontal relationship. Those two relationships are us-centric. They start with us. We love God and we love our neighbor. But Advent calls us to ponder God's relationship to us. That same vertical and horizontal relationship, but from a God-centric viewpoint. God so loved the world that God came to earth. The vertical relationship of God to humanity, and Jesus became human and dwelt among us. The infinite God became finite. and entered into the human history timeline through the Advent and the Christmas story. Advent is the season to remind us that God became flesh, that Emmanuel, God is with us, is God's pouring out of God's love to us. In Advent, we take time to watch and pray. We remind ourselves and we prepare ourselves for the coming of Jesus, for the coming of God among us. Over the past several weeks, we have preached, Dale and I have both preached, about different forms of prayer. And in September, we had a service of healing prayer. We've used hand and body motions as embodied prayer and embodied hymns, hymns and prayers without words, just using our bodies. We talked about where we fill our buckets. Some folks said in nature or four-wheeling or on the beach or hopefully in church once in a while or in the flower garden. These are all forms of prayer. There's many ways to pray. Doesn't necessarily have to be on your hands and knees in church or at the Advent wreath. We can pray when we walk. We can pray when we're just sitting and thinking. Some folks do some of their best prayer in the shower. It's true. Over the next 4 weeks, how do you think you will find ways to pray? Our family, the Ray family, has a tradition of keeping our Advent wreath in the center of the dining room table. And each night at dinner time, we light the candles. And over 28 years of marriage and all the different churches that we've attended, we've collected those little Advent bulletins, the devotional bulletins that churches often have. And I'll show you ours in just a minute. But our family will go through the stack of this collection of devotionals, and someone will read one of the prayers. And we try to gather for dinner each night and make it intentional throughout the Advent season. This year, Christine, in the office, put together the devotionals for us. There's an electronic version in the eBridge, and there's hard copies out in the narthex. But these little types of bulletins can be a form of prayer and devotional. I personally like to reread this book every year. This is The Christmas Child by Penelope Stokes. And it's just a daily reader with some classic art masterpieces in there that depict the Christmas story. And it tells the story from the viewpoint of the characters in the biblical story. So there's a story from the viewpoint of Gabriel and what Gabriel might have experienced telling these prophetic messages to the people that he visited. Or I might read something like a daily Advent devotional with, this one is just a book of theologians and their thoughts daily on meditations for Advent. How will you find ways to pray? How will you find ways to be watchful, to be alert, to be attentive to Christ and to one another, to pray always? What do you do to embody watchfulness? to stand up, to be on guard, to lift your heads, or to take heed? How will you find ways to pray always, as an individual or a church or a family? As we prepare for the coming of Christ over the next 4 weeks, how will we turn from the fear of the current times? How will we turn to the reassurance of hope that Jesus' covenant promises? How will we come together as a church community, as family, friends, and neighbors? Holy One, as we prepare our hearts and homes for the coming of God Emmanuel and the Christmas season, watch with us, pray with us, remind us to be attentive to one another and to you. Accompany us through the journey of Advent. Amen. Trusting in the sure promise of Christ and grateful for the Spirit's sustaining power, let us bring our gifts and offerings to God.
Why would he choose?
God of rightness, you have saved us from what the world, from the worst of the world can do, and have redeemed the whole creation in Christ's event. In faith and hope, we offer our gifts, that we may be part of what you are doing in the world even now, as we watch for Christ's coming in glory. Amen.
Go forth and begin the journey of Advent. Begin your preparation, start the planning. Look to the future, but in all you're doing, keep focused on the great gift, Jesus of Nazareth, the Christ child of Bethlehem. Amen.
Amen.